Hello, this is a video about two words that sound and are written the same way in Greek, but they don't mean the same thing. So just to be clear, the words I'm talking about is se, and the first one, so we have two words se really. The first one is a pronoun, and the second is a preposition. So a pronoun means it's like the words I, you, he in English. And really what you have here, when you have se as a pronoun, it's the accusative of a se. That's one way to think about it. The other way to think about it, this is the weak form of the word esena. The weak form or the short form of the word esena. Esena and se are not synonyms. You cannot use them interchangeably, but the meaning is very close. I mean, the meaning is almost the same, but you cannot use them one in the place of the other. Now, se, the second se, which is a preposition, we'll see it in a minute. It very often appears either like this or like this, yeah? But it can also appear in its original form. Now, this said to some people, this seems exotic. And sometimes I get students telling me, why does Greek has these words that sound the same way and are written the same way? Well, it's not something peculiar to Greek. It happens in many languages. It depends on the way the spelling system, the alphabet, was structured. And in Greek, because you can write the same sound in many different ways, it happens a bit more than in other European languages. But still, it's something that happens a lot in English. And here I have two examples. If you want, by the way, to look to find out more about this, they're called either homonyms, like here, or homophones. Yeah, both are valid. And the examples then, you have bow as a verb and bow as a weapon, like the weapon that they used in ancient times. Now, these are words that sound the same. A homonym, two homonyms are two words that sound the same. But sometimes, not always, they can also be written the same way. Okay, so now bow and bow, they are clearly written the same way, but you have homonyms which are not written the same way, like this knight and knight as in the medieval knight, or no, I don't want ice cream, or no, I know the truth. In Greek, you have a lot of this second kind. Homonyms that sound the same, but are not in the same way. We have a lot. And the reason is, as I said, that you can write the same sound in many different ways. Now, let's have a look at the first se. As I said, it's a pronoun. It is you in the accusative. If you speak other European languages, I have some examples here how you can translate this word with, how you can translate it. Normally, it goes before the verb. Yeah, and it can also appear like this, yeah, what we already saw, this, but it can also appear like this. So let's have a look. Σ' αγαπώ, which is I love you. Yeah. You can say σε αγαπώ, what I have in parentheses, it will be understood, and you can write it as well, but this one is more natural. Σε ξέρω, I know you, and σε βλέπω, I see you. Now let's look at the second word, se as a preposition. So it can be translated in English in a variety of ways, in, at, to, prepositions about space or time. Now, its position, we said the previous one, usually appears, se as a pronoun, usually appears before the verb. This one, however, its position varies. but it's never before a verb. So, you know, the sort of their positioning is mutually exclusive. And this is an easy way to tell them apart. If you have se followed by a verb, it's a pronoun. If you have se followed by anything else, then it's a preposition. This one can also appear as s with an apostrophe, but it can also appear like this, yeah? Stone, steen, sto, which is just stone, steen, sto. It's just a way of writing se, ton, se, tin, se, to. By the way, this is the only correct way of writing these words. You cannot write them like them, like that anymore. It's not considered correct, but what you really are doing, you're putting two words together. That's what I'm trying to explain here. When you have stone, you really have two words together. An example would be pas to cinema, which is simply to say, I go to the cinema. So now what I will do now, I will write down some phrases and you can pause the video and see if you can understand if the say here is a pronoun or a preposition. So if you want, you can pause the video now. Okay, let's look at it. I gave you a simple rule, so let's follow it here. If it's followed by a verb, then it's a pronoun. So here you have a verb after se, so yeah, it's a pronoun here. Here you don't, you have taverna, which is a noun, so it is a preposition. Again here, you have a noun, Athena, Athens, preposition. Here, I can't tolerate you. Andejo is a verb, and you should know that from the ending in omega. By the way, here, I could write it like this as well. This would be also perfectly good Greek. Both of them are fine. So, here, of course, it's followed by a verb, therefore it's a pronoun. And here you have Piraeus, so noun, so it's a preposition. Okay, now let me translate them as well. I don't want you. I could mean, it could be the meaning I don't love you, this one. I'm going to the taverna. I live in Athens. I can't stand you, I can't tolerate you, I can't stand you. And finally, I live in the Piraeus. By the way, this one, katiko, is just a formal way of saying meno or zo, στον Πειραιά. And that's it.